You know, Rod Nero Dixon here, and this is my review of the Simplicité 2-Slice Toaster 043-0880-2. Let's begin with the pros. The unit is very light. In fact, when it comes time to remove crumbs from the unit, instead of using the removable crumb tray and dusting that out, I'll tend to hold the unit upside down and shake it to get rid of the crumbs, because again, it's so light. Also, from toasting to when I could actually pick it up and dust it out, that takes, at, I'd assume, 2-3 minutes before the unit is cold. So it doesn't generate a lot of heat, and the outer shell remains, for the most part, cool, which is good. The toast slots are not very deep, so that means that regardless of the height of your bread, even if you're using hamburger buns or hamburger rolls, once the toast pops up, once your toast is done, you can still easily grasp the bread in question to remove it. The unit is relatively quick when it comes to its toasting. It works quite well, quite efficiently. Also, it doesn't take very much time. This unit will toast bread much quicker than my TFL unit will. When it comes to settings, I found that 3.5, as you can tell, it's quite simple. It has but a trigger mechanism. It has the darkness dial and a cancel button. One thing about the cancel button is it kind of needs two hands in order to press, because if not, you'll push your toaster away, because again, the toaster is so light. When it comes to toasting, around 3.5 will do the job quite nicely to give you a golden toast. The toaster will toast efficiently and not just superficially on the surface of the bread, but actually will toast through. And furthermore, the more you use the toaster, there isn't that much of a differentiation between the setting and the toast darkness on the first toast versus the toast darkness on subsequent toast. Now, the reason I mentioned that is because certain toasters, the more you use them in a sitting, if you will, the more the bread will become dark. So, for example, I've already had a toaster where if you're toasting multiple slices of bread, let's say you're making a meal for a family, by the third toast at the same darkness setting, your toast is almost burnt, which is thankfully not the case with this unit. On to its shortcomings. One, the length of the cord. The length of the cord is but 30 inches, so it's a little short. Now, here is the largest shortcoming of this toaster. It has to do with the width of the toast slots. It was indicated in the documentation of this unit that this unit can only use thinly sliced bread, and this is the truth. For example, prior I mentioned hamburger buns, hamburger rolls, if you will. Only the bottom half of a hamburger bun can fit in these slots. If you try to use anything thicker, like the top half, the poofy half of a hamburger bun, what'll happen is these guides will cut into the bread and it will bulge out around the guides. It will essentially touch the heating element, the toasting element inside, and you're gonna have, chances are, either minimally the smell of burnt bread. At worst, your fire alarm's gonna go off, so that's undesirable. So that is its huge downside. It really can only do thinly sliced bread. But other than that, it was cheap, efficient, it does the job. Mind you, I've only had it for a month. I've used it maybe 8 times. I don't know how reliable it'll be in the long run, but one can hope. Well, there you go. I'll leave you with that. I hope this information helps, and as usual, all the best.